3 inches of flow, easy motherfucking E with the chrome to your dome. Cruising in my 6-4 rack top.
I come from a generation of pain where murder is minor. Rebellious and more jealous, a chip you for designer.
Belt raps, but I can't feel that hardcore appeal that you're screaming. Maybe I'm dreaming. This ain't Christopher Williams. Still some empty that the feel one. Cats, I got the feel.
Hey guys, it's Rico, and I know I've been away for way too long, man, and I'm so sorry, but I'll explain everything in the end. What's important is that we'll get to the tutorial, which I promised. So we're going to be making lo-fi rap remixes, and this one in specific is the All Eyes on Me Tupac remix. So let's just get right into it. The first step is to just find yourself the acapella. And these can be found on YouTube. You just look for on YouTube and you find a good quality one and just go in here and listen to it. When you see me and let these devils be sorry for the day they Perfect. So now you download this legally, of course. Yeah. And then you just put it into FL. And then you just gotta find the BPM now. Now you can either look for online or you can do the classic tapping method.
Hey, you know what?
Just play it and then just like
I
tap
bet
it.
You got it twisted. You don't know who to trust. So many player hating.
Right, there's a lot of ways to do it, but usually they have it in the comments, and it's pretty accurate. Boom, there we go, 93.282, perfect, we'll put that in, right? So you just go to top left here, and then we do fit the tempo, BPM, 93.282, and now it should be perfectly in sync now. So now we can change it to whatever BPM we want. It will stretch it, and it won't move, because it will always be locked to 93.282. So now at 80 BPM... What? We just gotta match it. So like
bet you got it twisted, you don't know who to trust. So
perfect.
Many player hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the
Okay, perfect. And now it's on time and you can put as whatever BPM you want and it'll be good. Now the next step is finding a sample that is close to BPM as the original acapella. So around the 93 BPM mark. So it could be 70 BPM would probably be pushing it, or like 100 and something. But as long as it sounds good, when you slow it down or speed it up, it doesn't matter. It just needs to be in that same range. So the way I find these samples, right, is just by going on YouTube, typing like chill, lo-fi samples or something. And then playlists will pop up or videos will pop up. And I found this one in this playlist here. So let's take a look. And I'm going to be sampling this part. Perfect, so now you do the same thing again. You go and download it legally. And you just slap it in FL, right? And now you do the exact same thing. You just gotta find the BPM. So now let's try another method, right? Because I didn't find it in the comments, the BPM for it. So you just do this. And let's look for it. Type in the name. And then I'll just put BPM afterwards. And it'll show us. Two sources say 68. That's a little bit slow. So we're gonna have to speed it up. But it shouldn't be too bad. Let's just go by ear once we match it to the BPM. So we go to the top left, same thing, typing BPM 68. And now it should be on time now. Now all we're gonna do is just match it. Okay, perfect. And now what did you notice? That it's not perfectly on time. And a lot of samples are like this. When it's either like jazz or like an old school sample, it might not be perfectly on the actual BPM. So that's where we as producers come in and we just chop it up and we just make it perfect, right? So as long as we get it chopped up, it should be all good. So we're gonna chop it up for every single bar, right? So here's a bar, we chop it up in here. So this is gonna be the start of the sample. That's on time, that's fine. This bar's on time. This bar isn't. So we're gonna put a cut in here and then holding shift and using our mouse wheel, drag the transient to the front so it matches with the bar. So now it's gonna be on time and it shouldn't sound too bad. Again, that's not on time. Same thing, shift and mouse wheel. Same thing. A little bit here. And now let's aim for an 8-bar loop, right? Because in an 8-bar loop, there's more variety, so it's not very repetitive. And if you find any other sections in the sample that's, you know, very loopable, you just put that in. It's good to have multiple loops so you can spice up the beat instead of just using one. Especially one 4-bar loop will just sound like shit, you know what I mean? So I'll be right back once I've chopped everything up and I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, perfect. So I've done my 8-bar loop now and I'm just gonna play it for you guys. So now notice how the end isn't perfectly cut, right? So now we're going to do the same thing but essentially stretch the sample. So we're going to cut out the unwanted part here. We just want this part to stay here. And then just right click and erase it. And we want to stretch this so it fills up the rest of that area. So go to the top left, make it unique. So whatever edits we do to here won't affect the rest of the sample. And then we're just going to click the stretch button. And holding Alt, stretch it all the way there. So it's gonna stretch it and fill the rest of the bar. And now we're gonna double click it, right click, and reset the pitch. Because when you stretch it, when you make it longer, it'll put on a lower pitch. And if you make it shorter, it'll make it higher. So now it should sound super natural and it'll sound good. Perfect. So now we wanna, you know, instead of having many fucking different wave files, let's just make it into one wave file. Select everything, Control Alt C, consolidate it, click start, and boom. And then make sure you cut the little bit in the end off here. So you can perfectly loop it, and let's see what it sounds like when you loop it. Perfect. It's a great loop. So now we rinse and repeat for any other sections that are sampleable. And I'll be right back once I have a few samples. And the back, so I have two more samples. I'll show you the first one. This one. Now this is more of like a bridge, or if you want to call it that, but it's like a good breather before it goes back into the normal melody. So we're gonna play the sample as well as the a cappella and just see if it sounds good. See if we need to adjust the BPM, right? So let's try it out.
I bet you got it twisted, you know. I bet you got it twisted, you don't know who to trust. So many player hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the funk, but I don't think they know it. Straight to the depths of hell is where.
Okay, so let's hear what the acapella sounds like with the sample.
I bet you got it twisted, you don't know who to trust. So many player hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the funk,
this is fucking fire. Straight to the depths. Okay, sweet, sweet, sweet. I kind of wish it's a little bit faster though, so let's do that. But before we do that, let's actually match our new consolidated wave file to the new BPM, because we exported it at 80. That's what it's gonna be, 80. So now it should be locked now, right? So let's put this up to maybe 86. Let's see what that sounds like now. And also I did the same thing for the rest of the sample, so
I bet you got it twisted, you don't know who to trust. So many player hating niggas trying to sound like us.
Okay.
Say they ready for the phone,
yeah. Tough. I bet it. So now that's done, we can move on to the next step, which is going to be drums. So let's start with the drums. Now sound selection is pretty important, so we need to grab sounds that really sound, you know, like lo-fi. So I'll be right back, I'll choose some sounds and then I will show you. Okay, so I went through a few drum kits and then I found sounds which I think would really suit the vibe that we're going for. So this is the kick. very muted kick, you know, a lot of low end, not really punchy. That's what we want. This is the hat. Very like rustic. It's not a clean hat at all. It's like, you know, dirty. Perfect for lo-fi. This is the snare. Same thing again. And we have a second snare because I like to stack my snares. More of like a clap-ish sound. So now we're going to come with a nice pattern. And I'll be right back once I have a pattern and I'll break it down for you guys. Now, this is a very simple beat. You know, lo-fi hip-hop is simple, so let's keep it simple. Less is more. This is what the kick sounds like. Same pattern. For every bar, same pattern. You can spice it up if you want, but this is what lo-fi is like. You know, it's just simple. Now, a trick I really like to use is just cloning the kick and then just pasting the same pattern. There's more depth to it, you know. Might even lower it a little bit. Yeah, super nice. And then the next one is a hi-hat. And we have like a three-step pattern here. But for the beginning of the three-step, the volume is very low. The second is like halfway, and then the third is full volume. This creates like that cascading, like nice triplet effect. And then we have a snare, very simple snare. And paste the same pattern into the other one. Now with the sample. Two, three, two. With the acapella,
I bet you got it twisted. You don't know who to trust. So many player hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the funk, but I don't think they know. Straight to the depths of hell is where them caps go. Well, all your steel down, nigga, holler when you see me and let this.
But it's just missing one thing, and in my opinion, that is the bass. A really nice trick. It's just cloning this, making it unique, and we're just gonna call this bass. And then just assigning it to like a random ass channel, right? Now what we're gonna do is just open any EQ you have. I have Fab Filter, and we're gonna do like a massive cut on the high end here. And we're just gonna isolate the bass. So let's, yeah, that's already isolated. And we're just gonna play it by ear. Increase the bass by a lot. Perfect. Perfect. And add that as a bass. So now to avoid any like, you know, excessive bass frequencies and avoid clutter, we're gonna do the opposite for the main sample. So the main sample is on channel one, so we're gonna open another EQ, but instead of a super high cut, we're gonna do a low cut here, and then just probably right over here, right? Perfect. Now what I'd recommend is also doing a cut in around the 6,500 mark. Sorry, not a cut, but just lower by a little bit, because this is where our vocals are going to sit. So 6,500, yeah, like around there. So all together now, it sounds just sound like this.
You don't know who to trust, so many player hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the funk, but I don't think they know. Straight to the
sounds good. And now the best fucking free game I can give you guys is sidechaining, man. This will change your game when it comes to lo-fi hip-hop, at least. So pick any channel. Let's rename it to sidechain. Let's give it a nice color. And we're going to find a kick. Find a sidechaining. Right-click, sidechain to this track. So now we're going to find our sample, which is right here. And same thing, right-click, except we do route to this track only. And we do the same thing with the bass. Right click and route to this track only as well. So now on the actual side channel channel strip, we're gonna add a free limiter. There you go. And we're gonna go to compressor, right click in here and then find the kick. Completely reduce the threshold and the ratio. So now whenever the kick comes, it will duck the volume of both the sample and the actual bass. So it just sounds like this, very exaggerated. So we do some minor adjustments until we find the nice sound that we want. Already sounds way better. So because the kick sounds a lot more, we can really reduce the kick and then add our little mix to it. So our little mix is gonna be, yep, so we're gonna add a nice cut in here. You don't know who to trust. So many player hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the funk, but I don't think they know it. Straight to the depths of hell is where them cowards gone. Well, all you steal down, nigga, holler when you see me. And let these devils be sorry for the day they finally freed me. I got a caravan of niggas every time we ride. Hitting motherfuckers now, up when we it already sounds super full, you know what I mean? Like, it's just, yeah, really nice. And now you just do the same thing with all the other samples you have, you know, just cloning the bass for it. So do the same thing, go here, make unique and clone it, and then just pretty much structuring it now. So I'll bear it back once it's structured. And I'm back, and I know it seems like I've done a lot, but really it's the same thing you saw last time, but I just rearranged a few things, right? So let's just go through one by one. So I've started with the just a sample in the beginning, and then it comes into the vocals, and then the actual beat. I bet you got it twisted. You don't know who to trust. So many player hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the funk, but I don't think they know it. So I always add like a nice little sample in the beginning, so we can introduce a sense of familiarity. And then the vocals will come in, and it's just like, holy shit, you know, like, it's a really good, like, drop almost, right? And I've added some nice mixing to it. So all you have to remember in lo-fi hip-hop, in my opinion, is a lot of low filters, right? This will pretty much, like, make it sound damp and make it sound a bit muted, but that is pretty much what lo-fi hip-hop is, you know? And then just a lot of EQ. So in this case, we have the low filter here, and we have the EQ here, which I just showed you earlier, right? And then an RC20. So this adds that effect that it's like very like VHS-y, you know, very lo-fi hip-hop. But it is completely optional. I know this is a paid plugin, you know, whatever, right? The acapella, this is the mix for it. I have cut the lows because it gets super muddy with vocals. And then I've added a boost in the high end around the same, you know, 65 hertz where we cut it in the sample. And this gives it that presence. Another RC20, again, it's optional, you know. But I pretty much just have it on the default VHS preset. And then just a love filter and then a de-esser. You can use any de-esser you want, because once we introduce the high ends in the EQ, it will introduce more sibilance, the harsh sounds. So we're just kind of trying to mute that, just get rid of that, you know. The next is the snare. Again, it's just this time it's a preset in the EQ. So this is the phone preset in FabFilter that gives it, you know, that crackly sound. And this is also found in the default EQ, so I'll just show you quickly. You don't need all this paid stuff to sound good. It's right here. You got a preset, and then it's you got a preset and it's radio. Same thing. But I just adjusted like the actual strength of it, you know. So again, remember, love filters, man. Here is the same thing. It's got a radio for the hi-hat, another RC20, and the bass, just what you had last time. Boosted the low end and a love filter. The kick has a love filter and a boosted the low ends as well, and a cut of the highs. And then that's pretty much it, man. And insert 9, what is that? So yeah, and what else have I done? I've added a vinyl sound effect. You can get this anywhere on YouTube. Downloaded it, slapped it in. And this is pretty much what it sounds like. So now, to change things up, I have added a gross beat, right? Optional, but I like to have variety in my beats, which is why I have multiple loops, and I have this gross beat. So all this gross beat does is it adds like this nice like stutter effect, which in my opinion like really gives the beat character. So I'll show you an example here. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So now with some structuring and with all the mix, this is what it sounds like.
This sounds like Rico.
Bet you got it twisted, you don't know who to trust. So many player-hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the funk, but I don't think they know it. Straight to the depths of hell is where them cowards going. Well, all you steal, damn nigga, holler when you see me. And let these devils be sorry for the day they finally freed me. I got a caravan of niggas every time we ride. Hitting motherfuckers up when we pass by. Until I die, live the life of a boss player. Cause even when I'm high, fuck with me and get crossed later. The future's in my eyes.
Okay, so now let's talk about, you know, why I've been just gone for a whole year. I think it's been more than a year, actually. It's just, you know, man, lo-fi remixes have been so much fun, but I do want to grow as artist and just as a brand, you know, in the music scene. And I really want to take music serious, and I felt like I was limited by just doing lo-fi remixes. I want to make my original content. I am a rapper and I'm trying to be better at it, you know. And I'm also a producer. Like, I want to make original beats for my own songs and for other people and stuff. So, and I want to make stuff like this for you guys. This is my first ever tutorial, but you know, it's a bit fucking scrappy, right? But this is my first one and I'm only gonna get better at it. So that's what I'm gonna do. And I really hope you guys are chill with me changing up the content in this channel, you know. So this is my last ever remix, and this is why I wanted to do the tutorial so bad, so you guys can continue, you know, this lo-fi remix like genre. It's such a good like decision to start with, like this genre, because it got me into music. It's so easy to make, and then you just grow from there, man. Like it really is amazing. But all right, yeah, rant over pretty much. I appreciate you guys so much, and I already have a song release with my boy Tommy Davis called Another Coming, so please check that out on Spotify. I have the link in my bio and everything. And thank you guys once again so much, and for your patience, and I hope you guys have a good one, and I'll catch you later.
I ain't proud of it, the way I pick up my bitches. I'm faithful, only to the bag and riches. I be stacking cash, and I'm counting my digits. Don't misunderstand, I be sending a ton on my business.